He jumped on a grenade to shield a fellow Marine in Afghanistan and then had to go through nearly 40 surgeries.
President of the United States, in the name of the Congress, takes pleasure in presenting the Medal of Honor to Lance Corporal William Kyle Carpenter.
He said something along the lines, and if you'll allow me to paraphrase it, I just did my duty.
Countless shattered bones throughout the body. Countless, more than a dozen, something like that.
30 in this arm.
30 in one arm.
I'm an overachiever. I guess I'll take this opportunity to really say that everybody that's helped me along the way and everybody out there that makes up this great nation, I wear this for them, and I'm the same person a week ago as I am now.
Brothers, this past spring, on May 19, 2014, the Kappa Sigma Fraternity received news that our brother, William Kyle Carpenter, an October 23, 2013 initiate of the Chi Omega Chapter at the University of South Carolina, would receive the Medal of Honor at the White House in Washington, D.C. on June 19, 2014. The Medal of Honor is the United States' highest military honor, awarded for personal acts of valor above and beyond the call of duty. The Medal of Honor is awarded by the President of the United States in the name of the U.S. Congress to U.S. military personnel only. Brother Carpenter is credited with attempting to shield a fellow Marine, Lance Corporal Nick Euphrosio, from a grenade blast on the rooftop security post in combat operations near Marja Helmand Province, Afghanistan, on November 21st, 2010. Both Marines survived the blast, but suffered major injuries. Brother Carpenter's act is an act of a hero and a patriot. It's also the act of a brother of the Kappa Sigma Fraternity, who understands the words of the Star and Crescent, and who understands the importance of protecting their fellow man, even when they place themselves in jeopardy. As a result of this courage, valor, and honor reflected by Brother Carpenter, the Supreme Executive Committee has determined that the 24th Golden Heart Award in the history of the Kappa Sigma Fraternity would be presented to Brother William Kyle Carpenter in honor of this heroic act and in reflection of the values of our beloved fraternity. Brother Carpenter, would you please join me and the other members of the Supreme Executive Committee at the podium for the presentation of the 24th Golden Heart Award? Brother.
Official stuff is over. Where do I start? Thank you so much for having me here. I'm very honored. No super sophisticated, complex speech. Really, I just wanted to get up here and say thank you. You know, I spent almost 5 years in the Marines. I spent almost 3 years in the hospital after being injured. A lot of surgeries, went through a lot of stuff medically, but getting 2.5 years in my recovery and getting towards the end of it, they really pushed me at Walter Reed, and I wanted to make that successful step anyway, getting out of the military. I could have stayed in. I joined to commit myself to a bigger purpose, to wake up every day and feel like I was part of something bigger than myself. You know, I gave the Marines my best shot. I gave it my 100%, and now I'm a student. And getting to the University of South Carolina, medically retired last year in July, 3 weeks later, came to South Carolina, started school full time. So I didn't really know what I was getting into. I didn't really know what to expect. I didn't really know anything except, you know, waking up at 5 a.m. every day, going to run and training to go to Afghanistan. So, you know, I got to school and I hung out with random people here and there. Most of my friends that had gone there had graduated just as I was getting there. They were leaving, so I didn't really know that many people. Met a guy from Kappa Sig, fellow brother now, and yeah, he was pretty much a pain in my ass until I came and rushed and joined the fraternity. But you know, I'm so thankful and I feel so fortunate that we had that encounter, and I feel like everything happens for a reason. And you know, he said, just come over to the house for dinner, check it out, see how it is. And you know, the big thing with me is, I'm honest, especially in front of big crowds. I like to, you know, tell it how it is, and I think people can relate to that. So at first, I told him, no way. You know, getting out of the Marines and going through everything I've been through, he asked me, he was dressed up in some crazy golf outfit. They had just got back from a function. And I told him, I said, honestly, if you dress like this all the time, I cannot be friends with you or any of your friends. But, you know, it was great. He kept on me. He asked me to come to dinner, and I went to dinner that night. And 2 hours later, I was sold. I go in, guys are watching sports, joking around, messing with each other, eating dinner. It was just an incredible atmosphere from the second I stepped in the house. And ever since then, my transition to University of South Carolina has been incredible. I wish I could hit replay on this past year, and I very much credit that to Kappa Sig. Just everybody that they have introduced me to, the connections I have made that will be there the rest of my life. It just, you know, it's we're part of a great organization, and we're part of a great team, and we're part of a great fraternity. And you know, I think a lot of things start at the very base level. And with that said, you know, here at this conference, we're going to get a lot of big pictures, which is absolutely great. You have to have goals. I had goals. I want to move 3 more inches than I did yesterday. I understand goals, and I understand throwing the big picture out there, because that's something you have to work towards. But with all that said, when you wake up in the mornings, you know, it's really the simple things of life. When you wake up in the mornings, you know, be thankful that you can be a part of a fraternity. Be thankful you can get that education. Be thankful that, you know, when you go to class, you don't have to worry about the guy to the right and left of you not making it back alive from class. There's a lot of things we have to be thankful for. The fact that we can go into a room and turn a knob and get fresh water. I mean, that's like a Disney World concept to much of the world. You know, I watched kids for 4 months until I got injured in Afghanistan. Am I taking too much time? All right. Yeah, this is supposed to be like a little 30-second thank you, but see how that went. But, you know, I watched kids for 4 months before I got injured, kids that had just barely started learning to walk. With no shoes on, walking across gravel, through mud, through the fields, just to go out and work all day, every day. They're born and they die in the same mud hut that they grow up, that they live in, that they're born in. It's a different world, and we're very fortunate, we're very blessed. So when you wake up in the mornings, I would just say, yes, absolutely. You know, contribute to that bigger cause, that for our fraternity, a bigger purpose in yourself. The fact that y'all, you know, raised so much money this past year. I, you know, joined late October, so I kind of missed the first part of the fall semester. But the fact that y'all raised so much money for all these organizations doing great things is absolutely phenomenal. But, You know, when you first wake up, really think about you. Be thankful. Just, you know, put a positive attitude and a positive face on. You know, even if it's not the best day, it could be a lot worse. So, you know, people look up to you. Go out and make that positive influence. And there's nothing more that I hate worse or that bothers me when I go to bed at night and I look back at the day and know where in my day do I find something that I really tried to better myself, or I tried to do something, do 5 more push-ups than I did the day before. It's little things that work their way to being great things. So just know that people look up to you, and you're a huge part of your community and your campus. And you know, character is doing the right thing when nobody's watching. And I am in no way perfect, and I'm not standing here saying that. I'm just saying, you know, sometimes in life there is a greater and a bigger purpose, and just focus on yourself, focus on fraternity, but just really try to do good things, keep it simple, care about people, and try to help people, and you really can't go wrong. But I'm so honored to be here. Thank you for having me. Thank you for that incredible award. I truly appreciate it from all of you. Thank you for helping me get here. And, you know, just be safe tonight. I hope I can meet and hang out with every single one of you before I leave tomorrow. But thank you again, and hey, KDB.